You know, I honestly feel 10 minutes is more than enough time to hook you with a story, because I think when you're pitching a story, you need to focus on, you know, the central conflict of the story. What is it that, you know, the story is all about? So never go into, my advice would be, never go into atmospherics. A lot of people, sometimes I meet people who want to pitch a story and they start with, so this will be shot in, you know, the mountains of the Himalayas and there'll be snow. That's atmospherics. That's something that the director can decide for him or herself whether they want to do it. You hook me with the story. Don't give me the atmospherics. Don't tell me how big it will be mounted, how beautiful the music will be, and what great the locations will be. If you can hook me with the story, the director will decide what locations the film will be shot in, who the actors will be, what the music will be. So I think 10 minutes is more than enough. Honestly, you know, if I look back, most of the scripts that I've written have been, you know, scripts that I've developed myself. But if there's one example where I got a story from outside and I was hooked, it took me 2 minutes. When Vijender Prasad narrated the story of Bajrangi Bhaijaan, it was not even 2 minutes and I knew I'm doing this film. Come what may, I want this story and I'm going to develop this into my own screenplay. So I think it's more than enough to pitch. Even when today I say share an idea with an actor, I know with it, if I'm narrating an idea to an actor, I know whether he or she is engaged within the first 10 minutes. And if I see a blank look in their eyes in the first 7-8 minutes, I know that they're not going to like it. This is not touching them. So I think 10 minutes is more than enough to hook you. I remember my first pitch, yeah, and honestly, I had prepared a 2-minute version, I had prepared a 5-minute version, 10-minute version, and the full version, because I had written the whole script myself, and I could also, when I was pitching, honestly, in the first 5 minutes, I knew whether the person across the table is interested or not. You know, it's by the time you finished your fourth or fifth sentence, you've either got them or you're not going to get them. So I think the whole idea is to be able to, and that's the strength of a good story. You know, if somebody starts with trying to give you atmospherics, you know, there's no story here. He's trying to sell us and seduce us with some world that's going to be created. I'm not saying, I have nothing wrong with films that where a world is being created. I mean, we've just seen The Revenant, which honestly for me is more about the world than the story. But when you're pitching a story idea, stay away from the paraphernalia, go straight to the heart of the story, narrate the central conflict of your story, and that will hook the person. Pitching your story at every stage will be there, because the point is not, you know, I know that one feels that after a certain level of success, it's not difficult to get actors, but you don't want an actor who's not excited about the story. I never want to make a film where people are doing the film because of the wrong reasons. They're doing the film because they feel this is a big director, or this is a big production house, or this is a big film. I want the actor to react to the story and get excited. I want to do this film. And so it was very, very clear, and especially in the case of Bajrangi Bhaijaan, because it was in a certain sense the antithesis of what Salman had been doing successfully for the past 9 years. It was very important that he's coming on board because he loves the story. And it was honestly a 5-minute pitch with him. I told him this is what it's going to be, and this is one story where we'll have to stay true to the character. We will not have the usual, you know, trappings that we think are make mainstream cinema. He jumped at it. He jumped at it, and I could make out that he's jumping at it for the story. And that's the reason why if today people have appreciated Salman's performance in Bajrangi Bhaijaan, it's because he believed in the story and wanted to portray the character that was written in the script.